All right, guys, today I'm trying the bare camera technique. No cases, no mics. The problem is, as you've seen, sometimes I'll put my finger over the mic like this, I think, and then it gets muffled, right? So that's the only problem with a bare mic. If you forget and hold it wrong, you can block the mic ports. So I'm just careful where I put my fingers there. Quick update on my thoughts today. The downpipe is still off. I feel better today about stage one than I did initially. You know, I missed stage two at first. I don't miss it right now. The stage one is getting better and better as the tune adjusts a little bit. If you're curious what stage one tune I'm on now, I am on my Bren stage one tune. I also have a Torque Performance stage one tune. It's just as good, just about, but I like the Bren cold start sequence a little more, to be honest. It doesn't stay in cold start as long with the Bren. With the Torque, and this is all something that can be changed with the tuner. This doesn't mean it's a bad tuner. It's just you didn't follow through with what you wanted. You know, like I could have gone further with it if I wanted to. But for instance, the Torque Performance, even after about 4 to 6 minutes of driving, you know, cruising at 3, come to a stop, as the idle drops, and you come to a stop, it pops back up to 1500 for longer than I'd expect. With the Bren, it's a short cold start, maybe 3 to 5 minutes, and then you don't constantly get your idle popping back up at every stop when it's still kind of in cold start mode. That's the only thing. Both tunes are powerful. Both tunes are great. An extra special thing I've done, my new hood scoop is in the paint shop right now getting painted. I won't even give you more details than that. I'll save that for my hood scoop video. I hope you're looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to it, and that should be, I may have it back by tomorrow night, Friday night, and I may have a weekend project to get that thing installed. I can't wait to see it. They said it'd be no problem at all. They can get it looking like factory new, whatever. Only thing was the way it was sagging a little bit, but I really don't think that's going to be a problem. And I'm going to show you in detail what all these little clips do and where they should be, and even use some 3M tape on them to hold them in place. I'm going to go into extra detail on the hood scoop install this time. And I did remove the little nuts that were on it for painting, just so they don't lose any or any don't fall away. So pretty much that's the second thing I had to talk about. The next thing was kind of silly. Let me get this down. This is the Dip Your Car product that I bought. Those dip nozzles I was telling you about that are probably a big ripoff. I got 4 of these things. They're basically just probably generic spray paint nozzles. But as you know, with the, actually, I don't know if this dip even has, no, that's a different one. Let me find an original, there. An original dip nozzle is this. And they're super better spray, faster results, more volume by changing to this little nozzle here. It's probably a scam. I mean, I think I paid like $2 each for them, but and I don't have a Plasti-Dip project planned right now. I don't need to force one, so I'll just try out those nozzles next time I get a chance. And the last thing I was thinking about today, I am sure, I like the Stage 1. This thing is for sale locally. Anybody local that wants what I consider the best downpipe J-pipe made, if you're going to do it, Cat, Resonator, the whole shebang, this is there. But what I'm talking about, which I've talked about in the past, is just doing an intermediate pipe, the second half of that pipe. Now that one, of course, won't fit. It doesn't match up with factory. But a couple places make the intermediate pipe only. I think that is a solution I may want to mess with and play around with a little bit, because I will get to keep my 800 cell front cat. Most important for me, the smell, keep a little noise down. And although I know the intermediate pipe doesn't offer a lot of gains, I think it would offer some gains, 5 to 10 horse, I don't know. And I think it would be worth it for that. Now the Stox intermediate pipe has another 800 cell cat and a resonator. So one issue there could be that I could get quite a bit more noise if I change out that intermediate pipe with the, my screen went off, with the intermediate pipe with an aftermarket that has no cat or no resonator. If they make an intermediate pipe, you guys can tell me, that has either a cat or a resonator or both. If they make anything like that, I would be extra interested, where I could still keep the noise down, gain a little more flow on that real flat pancake stock intermediate pipe. So that's just one thing I'm thinking of. Even if I did replace that, I'd probably think about even staying at stage one tune. I don't think you're justified to have a stage two tune unless you remove that front cat, which is the biggest bottleneck. So I think it could still be a stage one tune, may just eke out another 5 to 10 horse out of it if you replace that intermediate pipe with a nice 3-inch piece. I do want quality. I think I know Killer B probably makes one, maybe PRL makes one. And let me know if anybody else makes one. And I just basically want the best fitting one that's gonna have no bolt interference, nothing like that. Got a little wind blowing, so we'll see if that interferes with my sound. I did have one last thing I forgot to mention. I know I keep saying that, is my tranny mount. So there's a good chance I'm gonna be installing that soon within the next week and trying it on stage one. I got gunk on my face, damn it. I've never tried it on a stage one car before, that tranny mount, of course. I've been stage two for a long time. I was stage two for a long time. So I do want to try the new tranny mount on a stage one car too. And that's another thing I have in the works for sometime later. That's all I got for now. I got to get back to work.